Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, the insertion, and the action of the semitendinosus muscle.
So we can see pictured here the semitendinosus muscle in isolation, and this is from a posterior view, so it's from the back. It can be a little bit difficult to understand its positioning in relation to other muscles without seeing them all together. So let's swap over to a surface view so that we can compare it to where the other muscles are located. So you can see pictured here the semitendinosus muscle. Some muscles close by are the biceps femoris muscle and the semimembranosus muscle. So you'll notice if I bring in the semitendinosus muscle now, the semitendinosus muscle sits on top of the semimembranosus muscle. So again, we can see just the semitendinosus muscle in isolation. Next, let's move on to the origin and the insertion of the semitendinosus. So you can see I've marked out the origin of the semitendinosus here on the hip bone in red. Next, let's try and describe which part of the hip that the semitendinosus is originating from. So we can see this section of the hip right here. And this section of the hip is called the ischium. So we know that the semitendinosus muscle is originating on the ischium, but can we break that down a little bit further and describe which part of the ischium it's originating on? Well, this section of the ischium right here is a slightly raised bump, slightly raised area, and that raised area is called the ischial tuberosity. So if we were to describe where the semitendinosus muscle is originating from, we would say it originates from the ischial tuberosity. So let's take a look at the insertion next. We've got our semitendinosus muscle coming down here across the femur, and then it's coming down and inserting on the tibia. So let's move the muscle out of the way, and I'll mark out the exact portion on the tibia. So the insertion is now marked out in blue. Let's describe which section of the tibia it's inserting onto. So it's towards the top of the tibia, so that would be the superior part of the tibia, or the proximal part of the tibia. And it's also towards that inner side of the tibia, so towards the midline of the body, so that would be the medial side. So if we were to describe the insertion's location, we might say something like it's on the medial surface of the superior tibia, or on the medial surface of the proximal tibia, depending how you wanted to describe it. So there's another thing I'd like to go over about the insertion of the semitendinosus muscle, and that's that the insertion, or the tendon, at the distal end of the semitendinosus forms part of a collection of tendon insertions which is called the pes anserinus. So the pes anserinus is comprised of three different muscle tendons. So the other two muscles are the gracilis and the sartorius muscle. So the reason why you might want to remember the pes anserinus is that it has some clinical significance. And that clinical significance is that it's involved in a condition which is called pes anserine bursitis. And that condition is a cause of chronic knee pain and weakness for people who have it. It can occur when the medial portion of the knee becomes inflamed, and that causes the bursa which underlies those tendons, the sartorius, the gracilis, and the semitendinosus, to get irritated. That can happen from overuse, or if a person has an injury, that can cause this to happen. So you might see this in people who are athletes, or if they've been involved in an accident of some sort. So the pathology of pes anserine bursitis is usually categorized by pain or swelling or some tenderness in the associated area.
So we're back again at the skeletal model. Let's take a look at the actions of the semitendinosus muscle. So it's connecting the hip to the tibia. So we're going to have actions at two points, actions at the hip joint and actions at the knee. So let's go over the actions of the hip joint first. So you can see we've got the hip flexed right now. And as the semitendinosus contracts, it's going to pull on the leg and pull it backwards. So that's going to cause extension of the hip. So extension of the hip is our first action. Our next action would be flexion of the knee. So obviously flexion of the knee right there. And when the knee's in this flexed position and we've got our semitendinosus contracting, it's going to pull on the tibia because it's on the medial surface of the tibia. So it's going to pull it medially. So our next action is going to be medial rotation of the tibia. And obviously there's going to be a restriction on how far the tibia can rotate, because you've got, you know, all the ligaments and everything else holding it all together. And if you overly rotated it, that would cause injury. So thank you very much for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed the video, you know which buttons to press. Press these buttons down there. I've also got links in the description to the other hamstring muscles, so go and check that out if you're interested. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you all next time.